You know, I've decided what I'm leaving behind me. Freddie's coming with me, forget it. I've got Freddie. Shampoo for the twins.
What do you want?
What I want? Let me say one thing. I apologise about raising my voice. I apologise about the argument. If we don't speak to each other, fine. You know, who knows what's better for us, but I'm just apologising, all right?
Hello everybody, how are you, you pair of assholes?
There's a stain on your shoes. Hello! Happy camping!
Hello!
Hello! And then we'll be leaving in a bit and off.
Yeah. We've got to go, goodbye everybody!
Bye. Yeah.
Goodbye, I won't be seeing your ugly mucks again. That'd be a good one.
11:19 PM. Tomorrow's partygoers have been making a cake for Big Brother's birthday. Liam and Chanel are in the practice room learning magic tricks for tomorrow. Liam is the magician and Chanel is his assistant.
Right, that's three sections right there. Right.
That looks like four sections to me. Because there's four bits of rope.
No, it's not.
It is.
This is never going to just be three ends, is there? We need two ends for a stinging piece of rope.
Sorry!
Brian, Ziggy and Jerry are in the garden.
Sometimes things do just...
I don't remember looking at you.
In this house sometimes, when we were looking for something new every time, we are quite fickle, all of us at times.
Very.
We will just run from one thing to another.
Yeah.
Say if right now we were having like a really deep conversation and a dog just ran in the house, I'd leave this deep conversation
and then run to the dog. Run to the dog.
It's so fickle.
That's it.
Ain't it really?
Like, talk for yourself, says her.
Huh?
No, but it's true. We are. All in our own little way, we are very fickle in here.
It does. Well,
it's not really fickle. Yes,
I'm not talking with people. I'm not talking with people.
We're talking in general.
I'm talking like in situations like you pick something up and put it down, pick something up. Things just interest us 5 minutes in here, then it's finished.
I've really let myself down as a magician not knowing this trick, mate.
But Liam, on the other side, there's only two bits to the rope.
Right. Can you ring that again? If I read it more times, then maybe it'll help.
I'm turning out a paranoid person. I cannot speak about it because I'm not sure. And I'm starting to look around about people that, you know, I like. And I'm looking at them and I'm thinking, I can't believe you nominated me. And, you know, there were...
Can I say something? I don't know if this helps you in any way.
Don't speak about nominations.
No,
please.
I'm not.
I don't want to hear.
There was only 20 nominations made. I was only allowed to make one nomination. And so was Chanel.
That's why I'm up for eviction.
Why?
This explains everything now.
Some of the housemates are in the bedroom.
Well, the conversation he's obviously had, it's upset him.
Yeah, and I've upset, so, do you know what I'm trying to say?
But what have you done to upset him? Had an opinion about something, probably?
He's just taking nominations the way people take nominations, I understand
well,
it.
Have you seen him being moody and nasty to anyone?
Nick, he's been as normal as could be.
He's over the moon, I saw his face today. He even said it before Big Brother did. Fine, I'm coming out. I'm going out with him and see if he's all right.
Am. Liam, Brian and Charlie are in the bedroom.
I can't believe how much of an extreme haircut.
Fucking extreme. It's like a fridge fan on his head.
I'm going on national television looking at
Fucking hell. As you, mate, keep your baseball cap on.
Tracy and Nikki are in the bathroom.
Yeah. It's been a fat time for you. And your time might not be up yet.
But also, I haven't had my friends and family to break my fall and cushion me and wrap me up in
You've had people around you.
They do, but well, that's what they're there
that's
for.
That's what they're there for. But in here, you didn't have that. And the people you've chosen to bounce off, I'm one of them, thankfully. I've had a fat time with you.
Of course you have.
I've had a fat time with you.
Of course you course you are, Trace.
You know what I mean? And it's been fat. Think positive. You've got that positive head on. Just keep it there, man. Don't let it slide.
No, I'm not. I won't.
I know you won't.
Hell no.
Hell no?
I'm joking.
Got the task to do tomorrow? Well, you've got to sit there and just lap it up. You deserve to be in that party. You deserve it.
Thanks, Trace. Yeah, Jerry, we're going to party.
Yeah.
How funny is that?
Jerry is in the diary room.
I'm coping better than I thought I would, but I'm also feeling terrible. It's a variety of feelings. I mean, it's not clear cut. On one hand, you don't want to be rejected by your fellow housemates, and it does. I do feel nervous about, you know, facing the people's feelings about me. On the other hand, it's not the reason I came here. The reason is I was craving for acceptance. And acceptance from the general public means that I could have been saved. Or not. Therefore, they don't accept me, they don't particularly like me, and that's it. If I go out on Friday and I have two or three people holding my photograph or saying, you know, Jerry, you know, they know I'm evicted, but, you know, they still like me, it made all these 6 weeks for me worth it. You know, for if there's just a very, very few people that, you know, call my name and they say, yeah, we liked you, actually. That's why I came here, Big Brother. And as I've said before, that's worth a lot more than the prize. Sorry.
Jerry and Nikki face eviction from the Big Brother house. Who goes? You decide. To evict Jerry, call 090-11-21-22-13. To evict Nikki, call 090-11-21-22-08. At least 10 pence from each call will be donated to charity, details of which can be found at channel4.com/Big Brother.